My name is B. Krishna, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Adhikavi Nanna University. My subject is Digital IC Applications. In that, I am going to discuss about Introduction and Logic Families. Integrated Circuit. Here, all the circuit elements like diodes, transistors, resistors and capacitors are integrated in a single chip. Let us see the figure number 2. It is integrated circuit. The dimension of that integrated circuit IC chip is 1 mm, so it is occupies very less amount of area. So why we prefer the integrated circuit? Already we have some discrete circuit. Why we go for integrated circuit? So before that, we have seen previously nothing but those are discrete circuit. In that, all the electronic components like diodes, resistors, capacitors and transistors are connected together using wires and make it as a discrete circuit. When I go through this discrete circuit, there are majorly affecting some parameters such as nothing but complexity, speed of the system and power consumption and cost of the system. So these are the major parameters are affected to improve the technologies regarding to these by using discrete circuits. So when the technologies improves, the size of the circuit also increases. So this is the major drawback, and also the power consumption is increases and the cost of the system also increases. So instead of these parameters, we will prefer integrated circuit. So the major comparison between these two is nothing but the integrated circuit is nothing but IC chip. It occupies very less amount of area. So means the size of the system is reduces compared to discrete circuit. And similarly, the speed of the system is increases, means the operation speed or functionality is improves compared to the discrete circuit. And one more thing is the cost of the system is also decreases. Similarly, power consumption. Like see here, figure number 3 is the like integrated circuit chip. Advantages. Here, advantages of integrated circuit such as increase the operating speed, improve the functional performance, reduce the power consumption. To means the utilization of power consumption is reduced and the size of the area is reduces, the cost of the system will be decreases. So these are the major parameters are considered for the implementation of integrated circuit for the future technologies. And coming to the logic families, so here there are two types of logic families majorly, nothing but bipolar logic families and unipolar logic families. The bipolar logic families are implemented by using transistors, diodes and resistors. Coming to the unipolar logic families, whatever we are implementing the logic families in unipolar, they are nothing but by using PMOS, NMOS and CMOS are the major components for the implementation of unipolar logic families. Coming to the bipolar logic families, there are again classified as two types. One is saturated, other one is non-saturated. Coming to the saturated means the circuit is performing whatever the device, suppose the transistor is available in the particular device. The device is completely in saturation mode, then only we are expecting the response. Such type of circuits are nothing but RTL, DCTL, DTL and TTL. RTL nothing but resistor transistor logic, and DCTL is direct coupled transistor logic, and DTL nothing but diode transistor logic, and TTL transistor transistor logic. Next thing is non-saturated logic families. Here The long-sided logic families are classified at two types. Think about it. Short key TTL and ECL. Short key TTL means short key transistor logic, and ECL is emitter coupled logic families. Before going to the complete saturation mode, the device is delivering the output response. So means the utilization of power consumption is reduces. So these are the logic families. Next, characteristics of the logic family. Characteristics of logic families. So these are the some characteristics of logic families. Nothing but speed, fan in, fan out, power consumption, noise margin, and propagation delay. Speed. The speed of logic circuit is determined by the time between the application of inputs and change in output. Coming to fan in, the maximum number of inputs that can be applied to a logic circuit. And next thing is fan out, the number of loads that the output of a logic gate can drive. Next thing is power consumption. The power consumption per gate utilization for the logic circuit is power consumption. And noise margin. It is the limit of noise voltage that can be present without disturbing proper operation of logic circuit. Next thing is propagation delay. The average delay time for the signal to propagate input to output. These are the some characteristics of logic families. Coming to CMOS logic. CMOS, nothing but complementary metal oxide semiconductor logic. Here, see the block diagram, see the circuit diagram. Here we are observing the major components for the implementation of CMOS logic, nothing but PMOS and NMOS. Okay, in the above figure, the input 1i and the output is O. Before going to observe the function of CMOS logic, let us know the MOS transistors, such are nothing but PMOS is a p-channel device, NMOS is nothing but a n-channel device. Coming to MOS transistor. So generally, the MOS transistor consists of three terminals, such are nothing but gate, drain, source. So these are the three terminals. The source is store the charge particles, and drain is collecting the charge particle from the source through this channel. If the channel is available in between these two, then only the charge particles are moving towards the drain by applying external voltage at drain. How the channel is established in between source and drain? That is due to gate voltage. So like here, that MOS transistor consists of three terminals. One is drain, and second one is gate terminal, and third one is source. And similarly, this MOS transistor is called as voltage controlled resistance device. Let us see the basic circuit for CMOS inverter, NAND gate, and NOR gate by using these CMOS logics. CMOS logic operation. Here, let us know the operation and transfer characteristics of CMOS logic families. Already I told you, the basic building blocks of CMOS logic is nothing but p-channel and n-channel. In p-channel, there are only p-MOS devices are represented. In n-channel area, there are only n-channel devices are represented. Coming to input and output, the common gate terminals of PMOS and NMOS device given as a input terminal, the common drain are taken at as output terminal. The source of N channel is connected to the ground, and source of P channel connected to VDD. So this is the basic construction of CMOS logic. Let us observe the function of this particular CMOS logic operation. Here, for gate input is given to the PMOS device, then the PMOS is going to on. Similarly, at the same time, the gate and the zero logic, zero voltage is applied at the gate of NMOS device, then the NMOS device is going to off condition. As well as logic 1 is applied at gate of PMOS, then PMOS channel or P channel device going into off condition. At the same time, NMOS, nothing but N channel device going to on. These are the basic on and off conditions of the PMOS and NMOS device. So coming to the functional diagram. Here, initially we can apply the input as 0 for the CMOS logic. Then the PMOS is going to on condition. Now the connectivity is available in between VDD to output terminal. So here the output response of the CMOS logic circuit, when we are applying logic 0 as input, then we are getting output is equal to VDD. That is nothing but high. It is logic 1. Similarly, if you are applying logic 1 input as 1, that is nothing but VDD as given to the input of CMOS inverter circuit, then previously the path is available in between Vout to output to VDD, that is disconnected. Why? Because we are applying one logic 1 at input of CMOS inverter circuit, but if you are applying logic 1 at PMOS gate terminal, then the PMOS device is going to off condition, and similarly NMOS is going to on condition. Due to that, the path is disconnected in between VDD to output. Now the channel is connected in between output to ground. So whatever the data is available at output terminal, that is discharges to ground through the NMOS device. So obviously we are getting output response is logic 0, that is logic low. Transfer characteristics. As I told you previous slide, there initially we are applying input is 0. Here we are taking on x axis is V input and y axis as taken as V out. Initially the V input is 0, then we are expecting output response is V out equal to output equal to VDD. That's right. Now slowly the input voltage increases towards the 5 volts, then the devices are changing its properties, changing its conducting properties. Initially, that is 0 volts to 1.5 volts, the P channel is going to on condition and N channel is going to off condition. We are getting output response V out equal to VDD. But actually, the output response is VDD minus VT. VT nothing but threshold voltage. Whenever the input voltage is exceeding that level 1.5, then both devices, the P channel is from on to partially on, and the N channel is going to partially off device, then both are partially in on, partially in off, then there is a path in between VDD to ground, then the complete data is discharged to ground, then the output response is unable to saying it is logic 0 or logic 1. It is difficult. Okay, it is unpredictable. If the input voltage exceeds 3.5 volts, then the PMOS device is going to off and NMOS device is going to on. Completely, the path in between V out to VDD is disconnected and the path is connected completely in between output terminal to ground. Then, whatever the data at output, that is discharges to ground, finally, we are getting output response is 0, that is V out equal to 0 volts, but practically there is a slight amount of voltage available, that is 0.3 volts. Next, basic CMOS inverter. Already you know the logic gate, that is nothing but logic NOT gate. It consists of single input and also having single output. Just whatever you are giving input data, that it is generate the output response as complement. Here, we are taking the input is A and output is Q. So, output response Q equal to not A or A bar. So, this logic gate is implemented by using CMOS inverter, CMOS logic. Similarly, as common gate terminal of P channel and N channel is connected as an input, a common drain terminal of P channel and N channel is taken as an output, that is Q. And the source of P channel is connected to VDD and the source of N channel is connected to ground. Already we discussed in the previous section, as A equal to 0, then Q equal to output as 1. Here Q equal to VDD, nothing but output is logic 1. Similarly, if you are applying input is 1, then P channel is going to off condition, N channel is going to on condition. We are getting output response is 0. How? What are the data? If how we can get in the output response as 0? If your applying input is 1, then there is a path in between Q to ground. What are the data is available at Q, that is discharged to ground through the NMOS. Finally, we are getting output response is 0. Next, CMOS inverter, basic CMOS inverter operation. So whatever we are discussing previous, that was here discuss in detail with the switching diagrams. In previous case, I said open circuit, off nothing but open circuit, on nothing but short circuit by applying input voltage. Let us see here at case 1, when the input is high, then the gate of Q1 is at 0 volts relative to the source of Q1, that is VGS1 equal 0 volts. Thus, Q1 is off. On the other hand, the gate of Q2 is at high relative to the its source voltage VGS2, that is plus VDD, thus Q2 is going to on. So like Q1 is off, it is act as open switch. So there is no path in between VDD and output. And Q2 is a short circuit. Now the path is available, output to ground. Data is discharged to ground through the transistor Q2. Output response is 0. Similarly, case 2, when the input is low, low means the P channel device is going to on condition. At the same time, the N channel is going to off condition. Now, the path is disconnected in between Vout to ground. Now, the path is available in between VDD to output. So, output equal to VDD. So, this is the basic inverter operation by using switching diagrams. These are the switching diagrams. Figure B is nothing but switching diagrams of particular CMOS inverter. Next, similarly, here we can design the NAND gate by using CMOS logic. So before going to the NAND gate by using CMOS logic, already known that NAND gate in digital logic design, here it consists of two inputs, minimum number of two inputs and generating single output. NAND gate. What is meant by NAND gate? If any one of the input is 0, then output is going to 1. This is the basic definition of the NAND gate. So, A and B are the input and C is the output, C equal to A dot B whole bar. So, let us see the truth table. A is 0, B is 0. In the NAND gate, perform the multiplication operation. Finally, it getting the output response as complemented. Similarly, 0, A is 0, B is 1. There is a product operation, 0. Obviously, C is output response is complemented. So, output is 1. Similarly, 1011. This is the NAND gate. Let us go through the circuit diagram. CMOS NAND gate. Here, in figure A, we can design the NAND gate by using CMOS logic. As I told you previous slide, in CMOS inverter, there are two areas. One is P-channel area and another one is N-channel area. In NAND gate, it performing the product operation. This is the basic conditions, basic rules. Let us observe carefully. Okay. For dot operation, nothing but product operation, whatever the device are needed, those devices are in P channel and N channel you have to represent. Depending on this condition. What is the condition here? Dot operation. So due to this dot operation, the device here, minimum number of inputs are nothing but here two inputs. So two devices are needed in P channel, two devices are needed in N channel. So the representation of the devices in P channel and N channel is depending upon the operation of the NAND gate. The NAND gate operation is dot operation. So that's why the P channel devices are connected in parallel and at the same time N channel devices are connected in series. As well as here, I was shown here the switching diagram also. Let us, you have to observe that cases for this particular 00011011 cases in the switching diagram. Okay. Similarly, as inverter, the common drain terminal of P channel and N channel as taken as a common input. Here, the P channel transistor Q1 and N channel transistor Q3. Gate terminals are taken as a common input, that is terminal A. Similarly, the gate terminal of transistor Q2 in P channel and the gate terminal of transistor Q4 in N channel, the common gate terminal is taken as a output B. And the drain terminals of P channel and N channel is taken as a common output. So this is the basic construction of NAND gate by using CMOS logic. For the first case, as you are applying A is 0 volts, B is 0 volts in figure B, then the P channel devices are, whatever the device are available in P channel, those are only P channels. By applying 0-0 logic, then the P channel devices, transistor Q1 and transistor Q2, both are act as short circuit. Now the connectivity is available in between VDD to output response through transistor Q1 and through transistor Q2. Obviously, we are getting output response Vout equal to VDD. By applying 0-0 as input, then transistor Q3 and Q4 are act as open switch. So there is no way whatever the data is available at output, that is discharges to ground. So obviously we are getting output response is VDD. In the next case, let us see the figure C. A equal 0 volts and B equal to VDD, then the P channel devices Q1 is going to short circuit and Q2 is going to open circuit, but the connectivity is available in between VDD to Vout, in between Vout to output response, VDD to output response through the transistor Q1. So there is a connectivity. Obviously, we are getting response output is VDD. But here, coming to N channel area, Q3 is act as open circuit, Q4 act as a short circuit, but there is no path available in between V out to ground, that is output to ground. So there is no way discharge to ground. Finally, we are getting output response is logic 1, nothing but high. And coming to figure D, here A equal to VDD, nothing but logic 1, B equal to logic 1. Then the both P channel devices are act as open circuit. Now the path is disconnected in between VDD and output. Now the path is connected in between output to ground. Whatever the data is at output terminal, that is discharged to ground through the transistor Q3 and Q4. Finally, we are getting output response is logic 0. So this is the NAND gate by using CMOS logic, circuit implementation and basic functionality with the switching diagrams. What we have discussed above, that is a functional table, and similarly CMOS NAND gate with the three input terminals. In previous case, we implemented NAND gate by using two input. For two input in P channel area, we are taking two devices. In N channel area, we are taking two devices. Coming to here, the CMOS NAND gate has three input terminal. The NAND gate is three input terminal. By using CMOS logic gate, then the three devices are in P channel area. Those are nothing but P channel devices, and the three devices in N channel, that is NMOS transistor. As usual, the NAND gate is performing as a dot operation, then they are in P channel area, they are connected in a parallel notation. In the N channel area, they are connected in a series notation. Similarly, This is the functional table of this particular CMOS NAND gate. 3 input CMOS NAND gate. Next, CMOS NOR gate. As you know, the basic function of the NAND NOR gate. If any one of the input is 1, then output is equal to 0. Okay, if any one of the input terminal of NOR gate is 1, then output is equal to 0. In NOR gate, perform the additional operation. Okay, here this 2 input NOR gate diagram is shown with a truth table, and any one of the input is already shown, told you. Any NOT input is logic 1, then output is going to low. Like the NAND gate, the NOR gate is also designed using CMOS logic with the functionality. Let us see the CMOS NOR gate circuit diagram. Here, 2 input CMOS NOR gate, as usually shown in previously, here the P-channel divisor in P-channel area and 2 N-channel divisor in N-channel area, but they are interchanging the connectivity. How they are interchanging? Coming to NOR gate, it performs the plus operation. Coming to figure A, plus operation for NOR gate. Here, whatever the devices are needed in P-channel area, those are connected in series. And whatever the devices are needed in N-channel area, those are connected in parallel, depending upon the operation of the logic gate. But here the basic operation is of the NOR gate is plus operation. So due to that, the circuit diagram is interchange. Similarly, as usually, the common drain terminals of P channel and N channel are taken as common input terminals A and B. The common drain terminals are taken it as output. Let us observe the switching diagram of 2 input CMOS NOR gate. Let us observe the figure B. Here A is input is 0, B is input is 0, then both P channel divisor act as short circuit, and similarly the N channel divisor act as open circuit, and there is a connectivity in between VDD to output through the transistor Q1 and Q2. So output response equal to VDD. And there is no path in between Vout to VSS. So there is no discharge path. We are getting output response is 1. Coming to figure C, 01 case. 01. For 01 case, transistor Q1 is on, transistor Q2 is off. So nothing but it is act as open switch. And coming to the N channel area, the transistor Q3 is open circuit. Applied input voltage at A is 0, and transistor Q4 attaches a short circuit, applied voltage at B is VDD. So now the connectivity in between VDD to output response is disconnected, but the path is available in between output to VSS. So whatever the data at output response, that is discharges to ground through the transistor Q4, finally we are getting output response as logic 0. Similarly, 1-1. So this is the basic function and basic operation of the CMOS NOR gate. Next, coming to non-inverting gate. Up to now, we have seen inverting gates like CMOS inverter, NAND gate and NOR gate. These are the inverting gates. Coming to the non-inverting gates, including non-inverting buffers AND gate, OR gate, are obtained by connecting inverters at the output of inverter is called as non-inverting gate. Means the output of the inverter is again connecting another inverter, then it will act as a buffer. Like buffer. Similarly, here we can implement the buffer, that is non-inverting gate, by using CMOS logic. Here let us see in figure B, the first two, there are two parts. First part Q1 and Q2 are the CMOS inverter. Again, the second part is Q3 and Q4, again one more CMOS inverter. They are interface one and another, like then it is act as a non-inverting buffer. Let us observe the functionality of this non-inverting buffer. Okay. Here, the input of non-inverting gate at figure B, we are given input is 0, then transistor Q1 is going to on, transistor Q2 is going to off. Now the connectivity available between VDD to first stage of output. So first stage of output is VDD, that will be given to the input of the second stage. Then Q3 is going to off condition and Q4 is going to on condition. Now the path is available V output to ground through the transistor Q4. So data will be discharged to ground through the transistor Q4. Finally, we are getting output response is 0. So let us observe here. The input is 0 and output is also 0. Similarly, if you are applying input is 1, then the transistor Q1 is going to off, transistor Q2 is going to on. So whatever the data is available at first stage of output response, that is discharges to ground through the transistor Q2, and the input of the second state is 0, that is given to the common gate terminals of the transistor Q3 and Q4, then that is 0. So Q3 is going to on and Q4 is going to off. So when the Q3 is going to on, now the connectivity is available in between VDD to output response. So output is VDD. So let us observe here, input is 1, output is also 1. So this is the non-inverting gate. Next, AND gate. Here also, the AND gate is performing dot operation. For the first stage in figure B, let us observe the first stage or first part in figure B. The, for dot operation, the P channel device are connected in parallel and the N channel device are connected in series. The output of the AND gate is connected with the output of the NAND gate is connected with another inverter, then it is performing the response as AND gate response. Okay, let us observe the AND gate. Here A is 0, B is 0. By applying the input, transistor Q1 and Q2 is going to on, Q3, Q4 is going to off. Now the connectivity is available, the first stage circuit output to VDD. So first stage output is nothing but VDD, that is given to the second stage device input. Then the transistor Q5 is going into off condition. The transistor Q6 is going into on condition due to the applied voltage at the second stage input of the circuit. Then the path is available Z to VSS through the transistor Q6. Finally, we are getting output response at Z equal to 0. Okay, observe here, A and B both are 0 and Z equal to 0, that is the basic function of AND gate that will be implemented by using CMOS logic. So it is proved. Similarly, one more logic here, suppose you can use 0 1 as input. A is 0, B is 1. If A is 0, then Q1 is going to on, Q2 is going to off. Similarly, B is 1, Q2 is off, Q4 is on. But there is a connectivity VDD to first stage circuit output response through the transistor Q1. Why? Because Q1 is going to on by applying input voltage at A as 0. Again, the first stage output response is VDD, that will be applied to the second stage circuit input. For that input voltage VDD at second stage input, the Q5 is again going into off condition. Again, the transistor Q6 is going to on condition due to the VDD voltage applied at first second stage of the input. Again, the path is available Z to ground through the transistor Q6. So whatever the data is previously available at Z, that is discharges to ground. So finally we are getting output response at Z is 0. So this is the basic function function of the AND gate by using CMOS logic. Thank you.